Hi, everybody. This is Tiffany, and I'm back again with another episode of Meet the Trainers. And today I'm introducing you to Mr. Fletch Fuller. Fletch, how are you today?
I'm doing absolutely fantastic. How are you, Tiff?
I'm a little jealous. I want to be doing absolutely fantastic. My new aspiration in life is to be like Fletch when I grow up. So, I'll keep working on that. Give me something to strive for. For folks who don't know you, could you introduce yourself to the Tac-Con family, please?
Okay, my name's Fletch Fuller. I've been teaching at Tac-Con, I think, since 2016. I'm a career law enforcement officer and trainer down here in Southwest Florida. The class that I'm going to be teaching at Tac-Con is called Keep Your Peace, which is a layman's approach to weapon retention for the responsible armed citizen, particularly from the perspective of concealed carry. One of the things I think we've talked about before in past Tac-Cons is that often the hands-on non-live fire classes probably need to be more emphasized because that tends to be the most neglected skill set for some of the concealed carry people in the gun community. So we try to give them a little bit of a taste of that about what those things are like and how to solve some of those problems that happen from 0 to 3 feet within arm's distance.
So you kind of touched on it. I was going to ask you what you'd say to the folks who are like, well, why do I need to know weapon retention? My gun's going to be in my holster concealed. And you kind of hinted at what your answer to that would be, I think.
We look at basically a three-phase approach to it, and obviously it's we go into a lot more depth in the actual class, but so I think it's like a 2-hour block. But from a concealed carry needs to understand that the weapon may be secure in the holster, but the situation sometimes evolves to where it turns into a struggle over the weapon, either in the holster sometime during the draw phase or at full extension. So what we try to do is we try to identify and discuss some of those dilemmas and some of those problems that can occur if it turns into a weapon retention problem during the draw stroke. So maybe an armed citizen is in the middle of drawing their weapon either inside their house to defend their family against an intruder or something like that. And maybe they're not aware of maybe a secondary threat or somebody waiting around the doorway. And it's not as simple as always saying that I'm always going to have my weapon in close, because sometimes it's not. Sometimes you manage to flag yourself or silhouette yourself, or the gun comes to the doorway before your eyeballs do. So we try to approach those in a common sense way, to where people can understand, get the general idea without having to worry about taking martial arts classes for 5 or 10 years.
Perfect. Now, folks who were attending your block, did they need to bring their own blue guns?
And what I have right here, if people aren't super familiar with a blue gun, basically it's a solid resin inert non-functioning gun. It's fairly robust, meaning that we can twist it, we can drop it. We're not worried about it getting twisted up or bent or broken. And the reason why I say that is sometimes people will say, well, I have an airsoft gun or something like that. Well, airsoft guns have moving parts. They're usually made out of they're cheap imitations of live firearms. So they may be metal, but they're real easy to break. So we really don't want to mess with those. A solid inert replica of whatever training weapon or whatever weapon it is that you carry. And of course, whatever concealment holster that you may end up using. I think I've got a keeper's concealment here just for appendix carry. But whatever it is that you carry, whether it's a 5 o'clock hip holster inside the waistband, outside the waistband, appendix carry, doesn't matter. Bring something that you are somewhat familiar with. And we're going to go through some exercises and drills that hopefully I think you can learn some life-saving skills.
That sounds awesome. All right, I am always excited when we have blocks at TACCON that touch on some of those things that people don't often get in your standard kind of run-of-the-mill square range class. So, a few of the things that may be a little bit, outside of the envelope for some folks. So, guys, if you're up for a challenge and you want to really kind of see where the ragged edges are in your skill sets, go to Fletch's class. So guys, Fletch is on, let's see, Fletch, you are Friday afternoon at 3 o'clock on in the hands-on bay. So the hands-on bay, the interactive classes are all no live weapons, no live ammo. So Fletch is going to make sure everybody's safe, going to get everybody in the condition that he needs you guys to be. But if at all possible, bring a blue gun replica of your everyday carry.
I'm going to have some with me, but I may not have enough to accommodate everybody. So if you do have one or you can get a hold of one, please bring it.
Perfect. But for folks who don't have a blue gun handy, if they're really interested in weapon retention, they should still come to your class, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Perfect. All right, Fletch, thank you so much. Can't wait to see you in Dallas. You be safe and have fun. All right. Don't let yourself get too down in quarantine and all of the.
Yeah, I know. I can't wait to be over with it. Can't wait to see you, Tiff. Take care.
Too. See you soon. Thanks.
Yeah.